Welcome to your online class, subject social science, class 5, unit 4, topic atmosphere. So in that today's topic is about the environment. Good morning children. In last previous session, what topic did we see children? We saw about the clouds and the rainfall. Yes or no? So I think everyone are clear with the topics. Have you all revised it? Yes, now shall we go to the next topic, which is called as the environment. So before going to the environment, can you tell me what is the environment? Yes, children. So our surroundings, what all we see in and around us is called as the environment. So how can we define this environment? We can define the environment as it includes natural materials and living things, including sunlight. So this is called as the environment. So again I'm repeating, environment includes natural materials and living things including sunlight are called as environment. Clear children? You have any doubt? Shall we go to the next one? Yes. Next topic is about the importance of environment. Why environment is very necessary for us? First point is about the healthy living. So to lead a healthy life, our surroundings has to be kept clean. Only then we can able to lead a peaceful life without any diseases. Second one, we have to depend on environment for food, air and water. So whether it is a living things or non-living things, we mostly depend on food, air and water only for environment. Yes or no? Then the next one is every individual has the duty to protect and safeguard the environment. We have to safeguard the environment. Only then we can able to have good in surroundings and also we can able to lead a peaceful life. Clear children? So again I'm repeating the importance of environment, healthy living, depend on environment for food, air and water, and every individual has to save and protect our environment. Clear children? You have any doubt in this? Yes. Shall we go to the next one? Yes. So our environment is polluted by three ways. One is land pollution, second one is air pollution, and third one is water pollution. So what do you mean by land pollution? You can see in the above pictures. Okay, this is all because of human activities only. So land pollution is where there are harmful changes in soil due to adding or dumping of unwanted harmful pollutants. So land pollution is where there are harmful changes in soil due to adding or dumping of unwanted harmful pollutants. So how we make the land polluted? These all because of human activities only. Okay. There is a change in the soil because of adding or dumping of unwanted waste products in the soil. So the land is polluted. So for example, we can say that land degradation or commercial development. Yes, we cut most forest for mainly for building purposes. So for because of that, what happened? The soil's fertility is totally less. So these are the main cause of the land pollution. Clear all of you? Yes. Shall we go to the next one? Next one is air pollution. So what do you mean by air pollution? Air pollution is a mixture of solid particles and gases in air. And again I'm repeating, air pollution is a mixture of solid particles and gases in air. For example, you can say dust, chemical from factories, etc. So these are all we can say that it is a air pollution. The air gets polluted. So we also inhale the air which is mixed with the gases. So this makes our surroundings also affected. Clear all of you? Yes. Shall we go to the next one? Next one is water pollution. How water is polluted? So water pollution is a contamination of water bodies, usually as a result of human activities. For example, you can say lakes, rivers and oceans. Now we can see the points or the day to be remembered. First one is World Environment Day is on June 5. World Ozone Day is on September 16. And the World Weather Day is on March 23rd. Up to this, you have any doubt, children? Yes, I think everyone are clear. So I think now we have come to the end of this unit. So now shall we have a small recap of the whole unit? First, what topic did we see, children? First, we saw about the atmosphere. What do you mean by atmosphere? Atmosphere is a blanket of gases which surrounds the earth. Next, we saw about the gases of present in air. Different types of gases like carbon dioxide, nitrogen, ozone, etc. Next, we saw about the latitudes and the longitudes. The imaginary lines drawn horizontally is called as a latitude and the imaginary lines drawn vertically is called as a longitude. The next we saw about the solar radiations. The sun receives heat energy from the sun in the form of the radiations. That is called as a solar radiation. The next topic we saw about the various heat zones. So there are 0 degree, equator, torrid zone, temperate zone and frigid zone. So the frigid zone lies around the poles and you can say that temperate zone and also the torrid zone. Next, what did we see, children? Next we saw about the wind, different types of wind and wind. What are the different types of wind? What do you mean by wind? Wind is a moving air is called as a wind. So there are 7 types of winds. So what are they? Planetary winds, monsoon winds, land breeze, sea breeze, local winds, jet streams and also the cyclones. So what do you mean by planetary winds? It blows throughout the year. Next one is the monsoon winds. Monsoon winds are the seasonal modification of the planetary wind. Next one is land breeze. Land breeze carries air from land to the sea in the morning. Sea breeze carries air from sea to the land in the evening. Then we saw about the local winds. So local winds are nothing but it is includes both land breeze and the sea breeze. Okay, due to the difference in the pressure of land and the sea. Next we saw about the jet streams. So what do you mean by jet streams? It is a arrival and departure of wind in India. So the air current in the upper layer of the atmosphere is called as the jet streams. Then we saw about the cyclones. So what do you mean by cyclones? A low pressure area which having winds which spirally inwards is called as a cyclone. Clear all of you? Yes. The next topic we saw about the clouds. So what are clouds? Clouds are very large collection of tiny droplets of water or ice. So there are 4 types of clouds. First one is cirrus clouds. Second one is stratus clouds. Third one is cumulus clouds. And fourth one is nimbus clouds. So what do you mean by cirrus clouds? Cirrus clouds appears like a silvery gray fish which blown by high winds across the sky from west to the east direction. Next, what do you mean by stratus clouds? So we can say that it is a grayish clouds which will cover the entire sky. Next one is a cumulus clouds. It looks like a puffy clouds. It resembles like a cotton. So it is called as a cumulus clouds. Next one is nimbus clouds. Nimbus clouds having a heavy rainfall. It is also called as vertical clouds and also the dark clouds. Clear, children? Yes. Next one, we saw about the rainfall. So what do you mean by rain? Rain occurs where the droplets in the clouds become heavy to remain in the clouds. It is called as a rainfall. So we also saw about the three types of rainfall. One is convectional rainfall, second one is orographic rainfall, and the third one is a cyclonic rainfall. So what do you mean by convectional rainfall? The sun heats the ground and the warm air rises. So as it rises, it cools and condenses to form the clouds. That is called as a convectional rainfall. So this includes thunder and also the lightning. Clear, all of you? The next one is about the orographic rainfall. What do you mean by orographic rainfall? A warm, wet air is forced to rise over the islands like mountains. So as the air rises, it cools and condenses. So this is called as the orographic rainfall. The next one is about the cyclonic rainfall. What do you mean by cyclonic rainfall? Yes. So an area of warm air meets the area of cold air. So the warm air is forced over the cold air. So when the air meets the cold air, the water vapor condenses and the clouds form the precipitation. So this is called as the cyclonic rainfall. Clear, all of you? Yes. You have any doubt? The next one is about the weather factory. So when the positive clouds and also the negative charge clouds meet together, so as we know, the light travels faster than the sound, so the thunder will be formed. So when all the characteristics are activated together, weather factory is produced. Clear, children? Next one, we saw about the rainwater harvesting. So what is the main theme of this rainwater harvesting? Is to mainly to store the rainwater and not to waste the water. So what are the techniques for that? First one is collecting the rain. Next one is filtering it. Next one is storing it. And how we can use them? By using them for various purposes, for drinking, irrigation, and also the other facilities. So one of this best method is called as a rooftop method. Clear, all of you? Yes. You have any doubt? So please revise all the topic, children, and today's homework. So complete the book bag exercise. Clear, all of you? Yes. Thank you, children.